Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to episode 5 of Assassin's Creed 3 Walkthrough. We're going to resume. We're in a fight right now. Hold B! Hold B! He's about to attack you. Alright, now attack him. I pushed A. Now attack, slice and dice, slice and dice, slice and dice. You're not slicing and dicing. There we go. B, 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 B. X, 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 X. I threw you into the barrels. B, 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 I'm blooding your face up. I do apologize, but I'm gonna have to kill you. Oh, I just stabbed you with my handy blade. And it totally killed you. That's right. I just destroyed you. In like 2 moves.
I told you.
I know you did.
I did as you asked.
Someone was there trying to kill me.
He's the one that drew that ship.
It's a trap. You won't know that reference for 200 years.
Then they can have you.
Whoa!
You'll catch us anyway.
He just decided to give us over.
I can think of something.
Us meaning me, and meaning you too.
You wish us to sail.
I do want you to sail into the storm.
It's our only chance.
Don't give me up, you bastard! Whoa!
Alright, alright.
I was going to protect you and your against your mutiny. And now you're just going to give me up? Well, that's not right. I'm gonna take your ship into a storm now. I'm captain of this ship. Bow down to me. Since you're too much of a wuss, I'll go do it. I'll do it! To the green. Here we are at the green. Go, go, what are you doing? Secure the rigging, B! Quick time events, here we go! Heave ho! To the next green circle. The Kraken is about to explode out of the sea. And suddenly it becomes Assassin's Creed, Revenge of the Because you not- you have to climb up there. Is that what we have to do? We couldn't run up the stairs. Get over to the green dot! Secure the rigging! Again! Oh no, watch out! It's gonna cut someone's eye off. Go, 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 go! Leap! Leap! What are you doing? You're certainly waiting. In the middle of a storm, you can't wait. B, secure the rigging.
We need more speed! Loose the sails! Hate them! You take the foremast! James, to the mainmast with you!
Deploy the sail from the yard. Optional objectives, limit health loss. Alright, here we go. We're climbing. We have to get way up there. Time to be a monkey. Where do we go? Left. Going over to that wooden thing and up. Now let's go. You can do it. Easy does it now. Easy does it. Fast walk. Easy does it. Deploy the sail.
We just lost our mast.
That's probably not a good thing.
Help!
That is the saddest help call I've ever heard.
Oh, get up, T. Rescue James within the time given. I got you. Don't worry, James.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
The ship is sinking. We should go save him. Or not. That's alright.
Atlantic Ocean. Day 72. We were on day 30 something before. So now were long gone from those days of mutiny and handing over your visitors.
Those bars of gold? Are they crackers? You don't look so good, Hatem. How are you feeling? Ooh. I hear seagulls. Oh, I'm tired. It's late at night.
Meet the captain at the bow.
People look pretty tired now. Maybe I'm completely off. I don't know. We're to go up to the bow.
There we go, now we got a fast run. Hello, Cap'n.
Make ready for our arrival, men.
Arrival?
Oh, never mind. There's no land. What are you talking about, Captain?
The gulls tell us all we need to know. Climb into the crow's nest and you'll see.
Is it not the gulls' nest? It's the crow's nest. Climb the foremast. We're gonna go all the way up there, huh? Fine. Let's go. Go. I'm going all the way up. Elevator time. Literally, all you do when you're climbing, you just hold right trigger and up. And you don't have to do anything. It just goes. It looks cool. Looks really cool. It's just really simple. Alright, we're at the top now? Nope. Still going up. Oh, okay. Now we're at the top now. Synchronize your surroundings.
Epic music.
Ubisoft presents. That was all the prologue right there.
Assassin's Creed Tree.
Is that supposed to be Boston? Is that where we're going? Journey to the New World. Mission complete. 175, Otis, 175. View progress? View progress? I pushed start. Took me here. Run away!
Run away!
We're in the Animus, just in case you forgot. We're in the Animus. Sequence 2!
We finished Sequence 1. Boston.
Master Kenway.
Hello,
Master
chap.
Kenway. Yes, may I help you?
Oh, you just grabbed my hand. Quite a forward person, aren't you? Charles Lee. Can I call you Chuck?
Need, I've arranged for your bags to be delivered to the inn.
Are you by any chance John and Isabel's
son? Oh, gotta walk with the NPC.
One and the same.
Your commission is with Edward Braddock, is it not?
Aye. But he's yet to reach America, and I figured I might... Well, at least until he arrives, I thought...
Yes? Out with it?
Forgive me, sir. I had hoped that I might study under you. If I am to serve the Order, I can imagine no better mentor than yourself.
Kind of you to say.
Easy, darling. Don't fall.
Impossible, sir.
Are you...
This way.
I'm going to kill you right now. Don't you steal oranges.
Boston's quite a
That's right.
City.
Hey, where are you going? What are you doing? Whoa. Look at that. It's floating. Whew. I'm going to make an Easter egg of this, aren't I? Alright, here we go. Check it out. There, when you first get off the ship, you'll walk and talk as a lady who spills her oranges, maybe apples. A dude runs away with it, you follow him. He lets go of it down here. Can I zoom in? That's a way of zooming in, I suppose. And it's floating in the air. There you go. First Easter egg of Assassin's Creed Tree. I bet there's more. Is there more down here? Can I do something down here? Warning, reduce distance to target! Or else you will die, because the Animus will break down. Target! Here you are, Charles Lee. There you go, there's the Easter egg. Come check out my other videos. And watch the rest of the Assassin's Creed playthrough. Walkthrough.
Hold a moment. Need to fetch a few things before we get to work.
I'll arrange for horses while you do that.
Where are you going? Alright, this is Boston. Shall we explore? Find a general store was our mission. Animus database, Crown Coffee House. You want to read the database a little bit, do you? Is this what we get to hide in? Hey, found it. Found our first bale of hay. Hey. Animus database, markets. Green circle is usually where we need to go. Hello, soldiers. I'll probably kill a couple of you during this game. Bunch of grapes.
Get back here with that, you rogue!
Did you just steal something? I wanted to chase you.
Damn, Spriggs. This accursed city
Whoa.
Will be the death.
I know you!
You seem troubled, friend.
That's because I am. Greatly so, in fact.
What's happened?
I was robbed. The old Balkan file. Though I've managed to restore what's mine, I fear it's ruined.
I'm sorry, chap.
You mean the book?
This is no ordinary book. It's an almanac. The first I ever wrote. Benjamin Franklin. Pleased to meet you.
Haytham Kenway.
You must be new to Boston.
Why do you say that?
You're still possessed of virtue. To stop and help an old lout like myself. I don't mean to impose, but... You seem as spry.
I am.
Should you happen to find my missing pages, I'll reward you.
Look, I'm not.
Sounds
sure
like a good right plan to me.
If you have the time, hurrah!
To help Benjamin Franklin, I think I'd do that.
Useless in its current state, anyway. But should you somehow manage to restore it, you'll find me inside that general store over there.
All right, the general store. I'll find the general. Of American
that
invention. Get it? You see what I did there? Alright. Animus database. Benjamin Franklin. Let's read some of the database, shall we? Let's do it. Animus database. 4%. Recent entries. What you got for us? We got a lot. Lewis Mills. Lewis Mills. That was the guy that we killed. Is a deckhand originally from where we British somewhat optimistically call Sunny Brighton. He got his love of the sea from his father, who was also a sailor. He first took young Lewis to sea with him at the age of 10, sailing from London to Boston on a vessel named the Windward. As he grew older, Mills kept working as a merchant marine, travelling the world, and gaining a reputation as a reliable and level-headed sailor. He joined the crew of Providence in 1752, staying with the captain and crew through a variety of hardships, though by 1755 he was thinking of moving on. Okay, Lewis Mills. Charles Lee, who's the guy that we just ran into. He's got a picture. Lewis Mills didn't have a picture. Probably because he's dead. Charles Lee was a British soldier who went on to be a major figure in the Revolutionary War. I guess he's a real dude. Lee's father was a colonel in the British Army and started his son off in a military career early. He was sent to a military academy in Switzerland during his formative years, and then in 1746, Lee became an ensign in his father's regiment. Lee was sent to the colonies in 1755 to fight in the French and Indian War, which was before the Revolutionary War. He served under Edward Braddock, and then later at Fort Ticonderoga. History was not my strong point. Where he was injured in the fighting. Lee recovered and later fought at Fort Niagara. Just kidding. I'd always thought there were a lot of fort fights fought. This is the quirky chap writing this one. He finished his time in the colonies with the British conquest of Montreal. Lee returned to England in 1760, possibly because he was seeking career advancement. He was named a major in 1761 and was sent to fight the Spanish in Portugal. Though his service record was good, Lee didn't receive praise on his return home. In fact, he was retired from the army at half pay. After that, Lee became a vocal critic of military high-ups and the British Prime Minister, and found that his military career had inexplicably completely stalled. Alright then. What you got there for us? Crown Coffee House. I honestly don't care that much about the relics, the places. The name of this place is somewhat misleading. It's likely this coffee house sold more wine than coffee, since coffee was only just becoming popular. Did you know there was a time in the world when coffee was not popular? It was wine and tea. And then we threw all the tea in the river, the Boston River, and we said, to hell with you! We're going to go smoke tobacco with the natives and drink coffee. I know it's hard to imagine a time when people didn't enjoy their morning cup, but there you are. If we go by the number of bottles they had in stock, this was one of the busiest taverns in Boston, likely because of its location. If you were arriving in Boston with the ships by 1700s, let's face it, you didn't fly in, that would have been the first tavern you saw, and since taverns were a great place to get information, you might as well stop there for a drink and the latest news. Sounds great. Markets, I don't care about this stuff that much. Lots of markets, I probably should know because of the game though. Paying for goods is another matter, as currency was incredibly complex. They played in lots of types of money. They sold lots of goods. Slavery was legal back then. European servants were for sale too. But they had a much better deal than the slaves were offered. Bunch of grapes! What? This is a place. Places are the Sons of Liberty! Might have even been its location. Might have been Darts Night. Oh, it was where the Boston Massacre occurred. That was a big deal. That's what really kind of started the war, the Revolutionary War. It was a bit of a tiff, and some soldiers opened fire on civilians and killed a couple of them. And then after that, it was Paul Revere's ride. I love to see the fact that the Patriots met in taverns to imply all kinds of things about them. I should point out the taverns were places to do business as well as drink, and the alcohol was viewed as more or less secure for all ills. You're waiting for a punchline, but that's actually true. Those are the kind of doctor's orders I crave. Perfect. Benjamin Franklin, yes! Born in 1706, Benjamin Franklin was a renowned inventor, diplomat, and one of the signers of the Declaration of Independence. Translation, he was a rock star of the age. Benjamin Franklin was born in Boston in 1706, the 10th son of a soap maker. 10 sons! I guess his parents couldn't afford a television. Also, there were no television. He began working for his brother in 1718 as an apprentice printer. However, the relationship was rocky, particularly after the elder Franklin found out that the younger Benjamin had been writing for the paper under a pseudonym, Silence Do-Good, and writing an extremely popular column at that. Human nature being what it is, the fact that the column was popular was probably the bigger problem. Benjamin ran away in 1723 and headed for Philadelphia, where he continued his career in printing and writing, eventually becoming the Pennsylvania Gazette. The business, I mean, not just a copy, eventually buying the Pennsylvania Gazette. That would have been one of his lesser achievements. He stayed in Philadelphia for most of his life. That is, when he wasn't making extended trips to Europe. Oh yes, he's a very busy man. Franklin had a talent for persuasion, and that made him an ideal diplomat. In 1757, he went to London to represent Pennsylvania in an ongoing legal battle with the Penn family. It was the first of several extended political trips to Britain, and he would act as the state representative for Massachusetts, Georgia, and New Jersey as well. In fact, Franklin was in Europe for most of the Revolution, though he was in the colonies to help with the writing of the Declaration of Independence. Franklin was a vocal opponent of British impositions of the colonies like the Stamp Act, which was an increased tax on stamps, I do believe, and other goods. It was other goods too, it was just stamps was the forefront, because they were always mailing back and forth, and stamps were therefore a precious commodity to be in communication. We didn't have email back then. It was a big deal when they raised the money. It's like when the postage goes up every time. But it was other goods too, included in this act. And although he first fought for the rights of colonists as British citizens, he eventually became convinced, like many of the Founding Fathers, that independence was the only real solution. Unfortunately, Franklin's change of heart made him clash with his son, William, who served as the royal governor of New Jersey. William remained an active loyalist. The father and son never spoke again. When he wasn't founding a new nation and destroying his family in the process, Franklin was a scientist, inventing things like bifocals and more efficient wood stoves, when he wasn't mapping the Gulf Stream and discovering how electricity worked. What have you done today? Made yourself a microwave meal and sat about in your underwear? Oh, well done, you. He was also quite the lady killer. Jesus, this guy, carrying on several friendships with women while he was in Europe. The records don't say what exactly they saw in him, and certainly not his looks, though. Maybe women like a man who's intelligent. But if that was true, I wouldn't be here. I'd be in Portugal surrounded by them, and you'd be looking at a blank screen. Benjamin Franklin. Oh, you. Very good, that's the Animus for today. And this is Boston. And this is Assassin's Creed 3. We're going to go ahead and cut this episode here. We're in the community, probably about to go, "Hello, cat. I'm going to pet you. You're going to rub your legs up on my legs. That's cute. I'm going to pet the animal again, apparently. Can I pet the dog? Pet the animal. Hello, good boy. How are you doing? You're a nice one. Can I pet you too? I'll pet you too. Why not? I'll give all the pets to all the animals." Okay, anyways, we're going to cut this episode here. Next episode, we'll go on into the general store right there. And we'll see what's up with this guy with the envelope. You want to say something to me too, don't you? What do you want to say? You have a game? I recognize your game. I'm not going to play with you right now. Intermediate, Six Men's Morris. No thank you. Maybe another day. Okay. Pause it. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you had a good time. What did we do this time? We learned about Benjamin Franklin. That's the most important part, isn't it? Let's be honest. We also got off the boat. We found the Easter egg. That was fun. And other such things. So, anyways, I shouldn't do this. I should just say goodbye. Goodbye. Have a nice day. I'll see you again soon. So long.